Have you ever looked at a TF2 map and thought, what would this look like with state-of-the-art lighting? Maybe you've already seen some tidbits from Unreal Engine, Unity, or Source 2, and want to see more. Well, you can, and it's not that complicated, so let me show you how. The first thing you need to do is pick a map you want to import and decompile it for its VMF. To do this, you'll need to download a decompiler. I recommend BSP Source, which is linked in the description and is what I'll be using in this video. After running the BSP source batch file, click on the Add button and locate the BSP of the map you want to decompile. These are located in the TF Maps folder, and I'll have the full directory both on the screen and in the description for reference. In this video, I'm going to go with PL Upward. You don't need to worry about any of the other menus, just press Decompile and save the VMF somewhere you'll remember. Now we need to download Blender and the add-on IO Import VMF, which are also linked in the description. I also recommend downloading Blender source tools in case you want to import specific models into your scene. Do not extract these add-ons. Once you have Blender installed, go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, and click on Install. Then double-click the archived extensions you just downloaded and check their respective boxes. Afterward, click on the three bars in the bottom left corner and select Save Preferences. Make sure that for the importer add-on, you have the TF2's game definition put in. If it's not there, press on the plus icon and then detect from a game directory and select your TF folder. If you see Team Fortress 2 pop up in this menu, then you're all set. Now that everything is installed, we're ready to import the map. But first, make sure you save your file. Alright, now go to File, Import, Valve Map Format, and select the VMF file you saved from earlier. This will take a while, so be patient. Once everything is loaded, we can navigate our scene. If you already know how to use Blender, you can skip to the next part of the video. If not, I'm going to briefly explain how to move around. You can zoom in or out with the scroll wheel, or by holding Control with the middle mouse button and dragging your mouse up or down. To rotate your scene, hold the middle mouse button and move your mouse in the desired direction. To change the orthographic views, use the numpad keys or click on the gizmo in the top right corner. To pan around, hold Shift with the middle mouse button and drag. Lastly, press Shift and C to reset your view back to the origin. There are many other shortcuts for moving around, so in case any of the methods I've shown don't work for you, there's probably another way to do them. Now that you know how to move around in Blender, let's continue with our scene. Right now, the 3D Skybox isn't working, so let's fix that. Click and drag over the 3D Skybox region to select it, then hit Object, Transform VMF 3D Sky. If it's grayed out for you, all you need to do is shift-click the dot at the center to make it the active selection. If you can't see the dot, you can also type Sky Camera in the search bar and control and left-click it to make it the active selection. Now the 3D Skybox is properly configured, but if you zoom out, you'll notice that the scene disappears. We can fix this by pressing N or this little arrow up here, clicking on the View tab, and increasing the end value. I'm going to increase this all the way to 5000 so that there aren't any issues. The next thing you'll notice is all of these dotted lines between the 3D Skybox and the map. These are relationship lines, and they can be disabled by going to the Overlays menu at the top of the screen and deselecting Relationship Lines. You can also disable these circles that appear around every light source by unchecking extras as well. Now we're ready to add color to our scene. This can be done by pressing Z and selecting Material Preview. Alternatively, you can click on this ball in the top right corner. Note that it'll take a few moments for Blender to load all of the materials and your FPS will drop, so I recommend toggling this on and off until you find the spot you want to be in. I'm going to go with this angle because it gives a good perspective of the map and shows some of its 3D skybox. Once you've reached this point, you're ready to add the lighting, which can be done by pressing Z and selecting Rendered, or by clicking this other ball in the top right corner. Note that this mode is super laggy because it's calculating all of the lights and shadows in real time, so try not to move around too much while in this mode. Okay, so let's say that you like this view and want to go ahead and export it as an image. To do that, we first need to add a camera, but before doing so, I'm going to switch back to solid view so that things aren't as laggy. Now press Shift and A and select Camera, then press Ctrl, Alt, and 0 on the numpad to snap the camera to your current view. If you don't have a numpad, you can change the bind by going to Edit, Preferences, Keymap, and in the search bar, type Camera, and you can change the Align Camera to View bind and anything else to whatever you'd like. If you accidentally move away from your camera, you can snap back onto it by pressing 0 on the numpad. Now you'll notice that the bounds of the camera don't fit around your entire scene. To fix this, select the bounds of the camera and then the camera icon on the bottom right. Now you can change the focal length by clicking and dragging left or right until it fits the scene. Alternatively, you can use the arrows on the sides or click one and enter a length manually. And by going to View, Cameras, Frame Camera Bounds, we can scale the camera so that it fits our entire viewport. Now, if we switch modes back to Rendered and click Render, Render Image, we'll get our finished product, which we can then save by pressing Image, Save As, and I'm going to save it as a PNG. Now, if you're happy with this version, you can go ahead and stop watching the video. But if you want to make your render look even better and see a few other tricks, stick around and I'll show you. Alright, so how can you make your render look better, and what do I mean by tricks? Well, starting with the latter, say you want to make a render by the last point. Panning and moving the camera around isn't practical and likely won't get you the exact shot you're going for. So instead, you can press Shift and Tilde to enter Fly Navigation mode, which is essentially noclip. Now you can get that perfect angle. And with that, let's talk about increasing the render quality. To demonstrate this, I'm back at my previous spot and hid everything from the background to help speed things up. If you click on the digital camera icon to the right, you'll see the render engine set to Eevee, which is Blender's default renderer. The other choice is Cycles, which has GPU support for those of you with good graphics cards. And generally speaking, Cycles will give you the best possible render, especially if you increase the samples. However, Cycles is much slower due to its ray tracing algorithm, so for those of you who can't handle Cycles, stick with Eevee. But not to fret, you can still increase the samples in Eevee to get crisper shadows as well as enable things like ambient occlusion, bloom, screen space reflections, and so on. It's kind of too much for me to go through in this video, so I'll have another one linked in the description that explains how to make Eevee look better. There are a couple more important things I want to mention before wrapping up the video. Sometimes, for whatever reason, Blender fails to acquire certain textures for certain models. In Upward, this happens with these windows. Unfortunately, the steps laid out from the importer wiki don't work in this case, but we can still fix this. First, you need to download GCFscape and VTFEdit, which again will be provided in the description. Once you have both installed, open GCFscape, click on the folder icon in the top left, and navigate to your TF folder. From here, scroll down until you see a file called tf2textures.dir.vpk and open it. Jumping back over to Blender real quick, if we select the window and then the material properties icon, we can see the directory we need to go to in GCFscape. In this case, that's models/props:mine/window1. Double click it and extract it somewhere as is. Then in Blender, click on the plus button and new to create a new material for the model. Go down and click on the dot next to where it says base color, then select image texture. From here, press open and select the image file you just exported from VTFEdit. Now we can select the old material and then the minus button, and now this window is textured. If you want to change the overall brightness, color, or shadows, search light_environment in the search bar, select the light, and then the light bulb icon. From here, you can modify those categories to whatever suits you. Blender can be confusing and overwhelming at times, so if you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments and I'll do my best to get back to you. Thank you for watching, this is LED, switching off.